a few weeks back, we did a video about former Halifax Mayor Peter Kelly. He was the CAO out in Charlottetown. Normally, when concerns, suspicions arise, like how Peter Kelly had, normally, over time, their expenditures will pop up and it will alert those in charge that his expenditures needs to be reviewed. Normally, people like him attend to push the law as far as they can before they're eventually caught and they have to stop. But on the other hand, there's some people that don't stop until they are caught. Now, Peter Kelly was the former mayor of Halifax from 2000 to 2012 until Mike Savage decided to run for Halifax mayor. Then he decided not to reoffer after he already offered to put his name back forward again. When he realized his competition that was laying before him, chances are he's not going to beat Mike Savage in the first place. Normally, when you steal money, embezzle money that's not yours, that belongs to the taxpayers, normally you have the police that will arrive, and they'll put you in handcuffs, they'll arrest you, and all that fun stuff. Peter Kelly is a man that always came through the back door, never for the front door, because he had something to hide. Peter Kelly, what he had done is similar to the MLA expense scandal. Normally, what happened back then, there was no laws in place. If an MLA wanted to take money for their own personal usage, there's no laws in place, nothing at all that holds them accountable, or nothing at all that makes them repay what they had taken that doesn't belong to them. As CAO of Charlottetown, it's the same thing. And unfortunately, because of the lack of laws that our province and federal government puts in place, they got laws with loopholes that often allow themselves to get off the hook for committing financial money scams that protects themselves. Because if you and I were to do it, they'll lock you up for the next 20, 25 years and could care less. But for them, it's okay. The reason why that is allowed to happen is because, like I said many a times, two things. Stupid people who keep electing them over and over again. And they know they go to people who don't know their politics or don't know their background, and therefore they'll target those people. In my opinion, I'll stick to my opinion, the police should be going to Peter Kelly's home, asking him to stand up, turn around, put his hands behind his back, reading Peter Kelly his rights, placing him under arrest, and take him into custody, because that is the only true way how people like himself understand that they're not above the law. And there is people that won't stop until they are caught. Now, the problem here is, like I said before, stupid people will keep electing these people over and over again. We've seen it in the Nova Scotia provincial election. Tim Houston, he's playing the old Justin Trudeau bit. Look how great Nova Scotia is. Nova Scotia is a third world country. Nova Scotia has a high rate of homelessness, high rate of poverty, high rate of people who can't afford to put groceries on their tables, feed their families, let alone unable to feed themselves. Our politicians are in the political game for their own financial setup and not our financial setup, as we the people are the ones who elected these people. My opinion, Tim Houston should be shown the door, just like Stephen McNeil. What a great premier he was. Stephen McNeil was a scumbag. He was garbage. He had a garbage track record. There's nothing good about Stephen McNeil. The best thing Stephen McNeil did was announce his retirement and leave, because that's the only reason why he ran in the first place, so he can build his own retirement. Peter Kelly, in my opinion, should be arrested. I spoke to my counselor, David Hensby, about this. David Hensby had stated Peter Kelly had not broken no laws. Of course David Hensby was going to say that, because there's no laws in place, or ever will be laws in place, that hold people like Peter Kelly accountable. And that is why David Hansby has stated he never broke no laws, because the province of PEI, I should say, doesn't have any laws in place that protects the people from corrupt politicians who run scams. Here in Nova Scotia, like I said before, we had an expense scandal. One MLA went to jail, but the love of God Almighty, what a big shout he put on. Give him 25, 30 years in prison. Imagine Peter Kelly in jail. He wouldn't survive tonight. I know people who went to jail. If you're going to tell on people, you're going to hang around the guards, secretly tell on people, you're not going to last. And that is how people Kelly keep rerunning, because like I said, he looks for stupid people. And because of that, I did a survey for people to voice their opinions, and I asked, would you re-elect Peter Kelly as your mayor one more time? And would you be okay if Peter Kelly was to become CAO here in Halifax? Your guys' response was not only a no, it was an old hell no. You, the people, had voiced your voice on it, and you expressed your anger. And you should be angry, because you have your right to feel that way. The part that pisses me off is people like David Hensy that will say he never broke no laws. That is basically showing your ignorance and saying he never broke no laws, because they only knew that there was no laws in place to begin with. So of course he's going to say that. So what I got to say is, we the people got to do a better job of electing the people who we elect. Peter Kelly, in my opinion, is a two-faced coward. He's not strong enough to admit our guilt like you and I will. And the other problem with politics is people, they go on, I should say people, yeah, people too. Some people will go on as if they're a perfect person. Then they'll go on, no, that person never broke the law in their lives. We all broke the law at some point in our lives. We all did it. And there's no such thing as a perfect person. There was one perfect person in the world, and people killed him. And that person's name was Jesus Christ. So think about it, people. We the people got to take responsibility for our own lack of judgment and our own lack of stupidity, because people like us allow these corrupt, hypocrite morons to go in office and get reelected over and over again, when we, you and I at home, have the power to end the corruption and take our province back into the hands of us, the people who elected them in the first place.